Oh my God.
Um,
Oh, here
two,
it is.
two.
All right. So it's recording. Go ahead, please, Bruna.
So, okay. So I'm going to talk about plastic. Actually, I'm going to talk about the ammonium nitrate after what happened in Beirut. I'm working with plastic. And now I'm working for Orica, the company that I'm working for. The name is Orica. They are from Australia. And okay, to talk, I think it's better if you talk about the explosive before you talk about ammonium nitrate. But ammonium nitrate is not an explosive, it's just one element of the explosive, because I think a lot of people are thinking the ammonium nitrate is the explosive, but it's
It can
not.
explode by itself, but it needs to combine with something else.
Oh, it's impossible. And I'm going to show you how the explosion happened. So an explosive is a chemical compound which, when properly initiated, is rapidly and violently converted into energetic gases at high temperatures and pressures. So, an explosive, the detonation is actually a result of a chemical reaction. So, this reaction, it is a decomposition reaction, but it's necessary some elements to cause the explosion. And if you see the detonation triangle, you can see three elements. So they are responsible for the explosion. You need a fuel, you need oxygen, and we need ignition. So if you have only one or two of them, it's impossible to have a detonation. So these three elements together, they can explode. So ammonium nitrate is just one element of this triangle.
So
So
there could be other nitrates, other types of nitrates.
yeah, yes. But the ammonium nitrate is the most common. So in the mining industry, for example, the ammonium nitrate is the most common. But ammonium nitrate, there are a lot of, like, you can use in the agriculture, for example, fertilizer. I think that is the
As a
name,
fertilizer.
fertilizer. Yeah, it is a common fertilizer as well. But in the industry of plastic, this one is the most common. And I'm going to show you the most common explosive, the commercial explosive used in the world. What else here? Let me see that. I put here. This ammonium nitrate is actually the oxidizer. So this oxidizer is responsible for making the other element oxidize. So the fuel is the element that is going to oxidize. So he need they actually they share electrons. I forgot. They share electrons. Yeah, they share electrons, and the result is can be really dangerous and can be really, really huge. But they need some time to initiate them. In the explosion, this sensitizer element is going to help the explosion happen. So sometimes can be the gas bubbles and sometimes can be glass bubbles, but this element, it's going to help the ignition. This is like the, it's simple, but can be really dangerous.
But there are proportions, proportions, the right proportions, right? Or
yeah, there are some properties that can be followed. There are the height density, the right density, the right temperature, and the right pressure. Yeah.
Okay.
And the commercial explosive properties. Anfo is the most common commercial explosive in the world. This word comes from the first letter of the words, like it's ammonium nitrate, fuel oil. So ammonium nitrate is the oxidizer and fuel oil is the fuel. So they together, it is a mix. And then with this ignition, they cause an explosion. And some properties of this explosive is the energy, and the result, it's a lot of gases.
Uh-huh.
So sometimes these gases are non-toxic, but sometimes they are toxic.
In the case of the explosion in Beirut, were the gases toxic or non-toxic? Do you know? Is it possible to say?
They are. I guess you have both there. There are both.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, have you seen the videos?
Yes.
Yeah,
shocking.
You can see the you can see the wave, like we call the shock wave.
Yeah, breaking the glasses.
You cannot see the you cannot see the wave. Oh, it was terrible.
Terrible, yeah.
I've never seen anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
For example, if you use in this photo, I don't know, if you use in this photo, in this blast, for example, 100, I don't know, 100, let me think. I think he used here, for example, 100 tons of explosive, and that explosion, they have like 2,000 more explosive
power.
Can you understand?
So
2,000 more.
But you're talking about proportions, right?
Yeah, if you have here, for example, 1 ton of ammonium nitrate, you have in that explosion, I think 2,000 more ammonium nitrate than this explosion here in this picture.
Okay, wow. That's huge.
Did you get?
Yes. Yeah.
And this ANFO is the most common explosive, and I think another property is the water resistance. Mm-hmm. So ANFO is not a water resistance,
mm-hmm.
and there is a velocity of detonation. This velocity can be like 4,000 meters per second.
Mm-hmm.
And they have a storage life. And this is really important because in Beirut.
Beirut?
Yeah. In Beirut, I think the ammonium nitrate was there for more than 6 years.
Yes, that's
so
what
it's another. Yeah. This property is really important as well.
Uh-huh.
And they have a temperature, so they have a right temperature to explode.
Uh-huh. Nice.
And here, talking more about this ammonium nitrate, it is an inorganic salt.
Mm-hmm.
With the chemical formula is this one, mm-hmm. you can see. And it contains 60% of oxygen. Mm-hmm. So that's the reason that it can like give oxygen for the reaction.
Okay. It's a good element to use in a blast explosion, right? Because of all the oxygen.
Yes, mm-hmm. because the oxygen, they react with the fuel.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
In the chemical formula. And the main component in many times of explosives used with the mining industry, as I said. And yeah, as I said again, it has a lot of applications.
Mm-hmm.
It's not just for mining, it's not just for blasting. And now in the picture, you can see the triangle again.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And now this triangle is for the anvil.
Mm-hmm.
And the name again, ammonium nitrate and fuel oil.
Okay.
And the message that is really important is that the ammonium nitrate is not an explosive.
Mm-hmm. By itself.
For example, yeah, yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you need this the three elements as I showed. And for example, we have a manufacturing and of ammonium nitrate. And we send this element to a lot of sites, to a lot of states in Brazil, and they are transported by trucks.
Mm-hmm.
So the problem is not the ammonium nitrate, but if you have a crash. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Have a crash and a fire starts.
Uh-huh.
This fire is responsible for the explosion. It's not just the ammonium nitrate. So if you have a fire, it can start the explosion.
Uh-huh.
So it's danger. The transportation it's danger, but just if something happens, but otherwise, it's really okay, because when it is transporting, when the ammonium nitrate is taken to the sites, the composition of the commercial explosive is just made before the blasting, like some minutes before the blasting.
Mm-hmm.
They use a specific truck to do the mix.
Uh-huh.
And then they charge the blast hole. But otherwise, the ammonium nitrate, the storage.
Uh-huh.
You understand storage? I don't know if I'm saying the right.
Yes, storage, yeah. But how much time would it be safely... would be a safe time for it to be stored. So it's 6 years, definitely. It's definitely too much, right? Definitely,
yeah,
a lot.
I don't know exactly how much time.
Uh-huh.
But I think it's a long time. It's not just like months. You have time. You can keep it in a safe place with the density controlled and with the water, the humidity of the place controlled.
Mm-hmm.
But if you mix it with fuel, for example, you have just some days or some months. So when the composition, when these elements are together,
mm-hmm.
this life storage is reduced. But when it is just the ammonium nitrate, I think you have like you have you can keep it in a safe place for some years. But the problem is that when they are together, so it's easy to have an explosion if oxygen is with the fuel. But it's not easy to get to have like explosion if you have just the ammonium nitrate, just one element of the chemical reaction.
Yeah, they are still investigating what happened, what ignited, what started or ignited the explosion.
I think they have like some fireworks.
Fireworks.
Because there, it was like a manufacturer of fireworks. And
not a good idea to store ammonium nitrate right next to the fireworks.
And the fireworks, I think, was responsible for the ignition of this reaction of oxygen with fuel over there. But I don't know. Yeah, they don't know, but they know. They know that this the amount of ammonium nitrate was really huge.
Uh-huh.
Was not safe.
Yeah.
So maybe, ammonium nitrate was responsible for the explosion, but not really the responsible because they were not together, like the fireworks started.
There was an accident there, probably. Bruna, thank you a lot for your presentation. This is very, very cool.
Good
job.